Good afternoon. In the previous session, we have seen relations, definition of relation, the properties of relations which are given as reflexive, symmetric, antisymmetric, transitive, and then we have also seen a brief introduction on equivalence relation. Now, in today's class, we will see the next topic, which is combining relations. So let's see the next topic, combining relations. Relations are sets, and therefore we can apply the usual set operations on them. Because relations from A to B are subsets of A cross B, two relations from A to B can be combined in any way. The two sets are combined. What are the set operations we have studied already in Unit 1? We have studied about union operation and intersection operation and also difference. So the same way, we can apply the same kind of operations on relations. So let's see the different operations first. If we have two relations, R1 and R2, and both of them are from a set A to set B, then we can combine them to R1 union R2, R1 intersection R2, or R1 minus R2. In each case, the result will be another relation from A to B, or since in this case we are taking R1 and R2 from R1 to R2. Now, so for this, first and foremost, let's see an example. So let's assume that we have the sets A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, on these two sets, we have the relations R1 and R2. The relations R1 is equal to 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. And we have then R2, which is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Now, what will be the union of R1 and R2? Let's see that. So first we are seeing union, R1 union R2, which is equal to, we have to write all the pairs of both R1 and R2. So first we will write R1 pairs. We have 1, 1. Then 1, 1 is common both. For both, then we have 1, 2. It is not there in R1, but it is there in R2, and since it is the union, we will write 1, 2. After that, we have 1, 3 and 1, 4. We don't have it in R1, but still, since union, so write all of them. And then 2, 2, 3, 3 are not in R2, yet it is the union, so write even these ordered pairs. So this is the union R1, union R2. It is similar to the union that we usually do in sets. Now, the next one is R1 intersection R2. Now, which is the common ordered pair of R1 and R2? So let's see first. 1, 1, it is there in both R1 and R2. What about 2, 2? 2, 2 is in R1 but not in R2. Similarly, 3, 3 is also in R1 but not in R2. What about 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4? They are in R2 but not R1. So the only common ordered pair is 1, 1. So let's write that 1, 1. Now, finally, we have to find difference R1 minus R2. So when we do R1 minus R2, what we do is, from R1, we will remove the common element which is common to R1 and R2 and write only the elements of R1, because we are taking out the common elements from R1 and R2 and writing only the element. So let me just write it over here. So first, what is R1? 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3 minus the R2 relation, which is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4. Now, strike off the common elements from R1 and R2. So let's strike it off. These are the common elements. Now, whatever leftover element of R1, you are supposed to write that. That is R1 minus R2. The same thing we have already studied in sets. Now, similarly, we have to write R2 minus R1. So in this case, the opposite will be written. So one second. So this is being removed and we will write R2 first and then R1. Then cancel the common elements. Whatever are the remaining elements of R2 is our solution. So this will be 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4. So these are the different operations which are performed on two relations which are based on sets A and B. Okay. Now, in the case of combining relations, apart from union, intersection and difference, we have another important way to combine the relation. What is that? We will see. So that another way to combine the relation is the phrase known as composite. That is, when we have two relations, we can create a composite relation also. Now, what is this composite relation? Let's see the definition first. Let R be a relation from a set A to a set B and S a relation from B to a set C. The composite of R and S is the relation consisting of ordered pairs A, C where A belongs to A, C belongs to C and for which there exists an element B belongs to B such that A, B belongs to R and B, C belongs to R. We denote the composite of R and S by S circle R. Okay. Now, what does this statement mean? Let's see this with the help of an example. Okay. So, what is the composite example? What is the composite of the relation R and S? The relation R and S where they are defined as follows. Now, R is given as 1, 1, 1, 4, 2, 3, 3, 1 and 3, 4. S is given as 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 1, 3, 2 and 4, 1. So for this, let's see the solution. We need the composite relation of R and S. The composite relation of R and S is given as follows. It is given by the notation S circle R and it is constructed in this way. Let's see. Suppose, first I'll show you with one example. For example, the ordered pair 2,3 in R and 3,1 in S. We have 2,3 in R and 3,1 in S. They produce the ordered pair 2,3,3,1. It is kind of similar to transitive but not exactly transitive. So 2,3 and 3,1 will give us T1. 2,1. Now if you recognize, this is similar to the functions, composition of function topic or concept. So now 2,3 in R and 3,1 in S will give the composite as 2,1. That is, we'll exclude this 3 which is common for both the ordered pairs. So now let's see S circle R. So first we will start from 1,1, 1,1 and 1,0. We have 1,1, 1,0. We will exclude this common 1 and we will write the ordered pair 1,0. It will be easier for the next one. We have 1, 4 and 4, 1. So let's write it over here only. 1, 4 and 4, 1. Exclude this 4. We will be writing 1, 1. Then we have 2, 3 and 3, 1. So as I said, we already studied this 2, 1. Then we have 3, 1. And which is the common, which is the ordered pair which is starting with 1 in this S case? It is 1, 0. So 3, 1 in R and 1, 0 in S will give us 1 if not written or excluded. So it will give us 3, 0. And then 3, 4 and 4, 1 will give us 3, 1. Okay. So this is the ordered pair for the composite relation S circle R. Okay. Now, in other words, if relation R contains a pair A, B and relation S contains a pair B, C, then S circle R contains a pair A, C. We exclude the common element. Now, we already know that functions are just special cases of relations. That is, if we are mapping the function, we map usually each element in the domain onto exactly one element in the codomain. So functions are basically a special case. In relations, what we can do is, we can map multiple elements in the codomain, but in the case of functions, we only map exactly one element. So if we formally convert two functions into relations, that is, write them down as sets of ordered pairs, the composite of these relations will be exactly the same as the composite of the function. Now, apart from that, suppose R be a relation on a set A, the powers R^n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on are defined inductively by, so R^1 will be equal to R and R^n+1 will be equal to R^n circle R. Okay. So generally, suppose if I am writing R^1, it is R. What will be R square? R square is 2, 1+1. Okay. So R circle R. Okay. What will be R cube? R cube is 2+1. So R square circle R. It is an easy concept, not difficult to understand. And R square, what can it be written as? It is R circle R. So R circle R circle R. That is the number of times we are supposed to write the composite for that many number of times. Okay. Now, with respect to this, let's see an example. Let R is equal to 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, 3. Now, find the powers R^n. N is equal to 2, 3, 4 and so on. Because R^1 is 1. R^1 is R. R square will be R circle R. Now what is R square? Let's write it. When we find the composite with the same R, 1, 1 will give us 1, 1. 2, 1 and then again 1, 1 will give us 2, 1. I'll write it over here so it is easier to understand. We have 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, 3. And similarly in another R also we will have the same. So what will be R circle R? 1, 1. We will match it with this. So we will get anyway again 1, 1. 2, 1 we have to match it with this one. So 2, 1, then 3, 2 with 2, 1 will give us 3, 1, and then 4, 3 with 3, 2 will give us 4, 2. Now again, after that R cube, if we take R cube, we will get R square should be odd with R, or R, sorry, not odd, R square should be create, R square composite should be taken with R. So let's write that R square, that is simply R square R. So whenever we take R square R, the composite of R and S is denoted by S circle R. So here we will write first R, which is 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, and 4, 3. And this is given as 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2. Now 1, 1 with 1, 1 will give us again 1, 1. 2, 1 with 1, 1 will give us 2, 1. 3, 2 with 2, 1 will give us 3, 1. 4, 3 with 3, 1 will give us 4, 1. So R power 4, if you find out, please do it as a exercise, that find R power 4, it will be R cube composite R, okay? And then you will see that, you will see some kind of result, R4 will be equal to one of these, okay? And if you find R5, R6, R7, all of them will be the same. So do it as an exercise, and you can approach me for any clarification on the same. Also, you can verify your answer from the textbook. It is the example 22 of your textbook, relation and their properties topic. Now, moving on to the next topic, energy relations and applications. So now, instead of the binary relations where we always had a relation on two sets, we will be seeing relations on more than two sets. So relationships among elements of more than two sets often occur. So for instance, there is a relationship involving, if we are creating a relation involving the name of a student, the student's department, student's CGPA, and also the student's roll number. Now, similarly, instead of the student example, we have the example of an airline. We have the flight number, starting point, destination, and departure time and arrival time. So in this case, instead of having relation between just two sets, we have relation between multiple sets. So this kind of relationships are called as energy relations. That is, N here defines the number of relations that you can have. These relations are used to represent computer databases. They represent computer database. These representations also help us answer queries about the information stored in the databases. Now let's see the definition for the same. In order to study an interesting application of relations, namely databases, that is, if we want to study the subject of database management system, we first need to understand the concept of binary relations to energy relations. So we have already studied binary relations. Now we have energy relations. Suppose if we have A1, A2, and so on up to AN sets, an NRE relation on these sets is a subset of the cross product of all these sets, A1 cross A2 cross and so on up to AN. The sets A1, A2 and AN are called the domains of the relation, and how many ever sets we have, that is the degree. That is the degree of our relation. Suppose if we have a relation A comma B comma C such that A should be equal to 2B and B should be equal to 2C with all A, B, C belonging to natural numbers. Now what is the degree of R? The degree of R will be the number of elements we have in the ordered pair. So we have 1, 2, 3. So we have 3 elements. The degree of R is 3. What are its domains? Its domains are equal to the set of integers, positive integers, or you can even write over here natural numbers. Now, if 2, 4, 8 in R, so for this, we have to verify this condition. A is 2, B is 4, C is 8. Is A equal to 2B? A is 2, B is 2 into 4, 8. So no. So this 2, 4, 8 is not in R. No. Now, is 4, 2, 1 in R? Please pause the video and try to do it. So A is 4. B is 2 and C is 1. Now, A is equal to 2B. Check. 4 is equal to 2 into 2. It is correct. And we have to check this condition also. B is equal to 2C. B is 2. C is 1. 2 into 1. It is also equal. So, is 4 to 1 in R? Yes. So, this is an example for NRE relation. Now, we will be seeing databases and relations. A database consists of n tuples called records, which are made up of fields. Okay, now, what is this n tuple? A tuple in the database is known as a row. So, this is your tuple. One single row in the database is a tuple. And apart from that, If the student is doing major in computer science and mathematics, then both of them are known as a record, while each one by themselves is a field. Okay. So these fields are the entries of the n-tuples. The relational data model represents a database as an NRE relation, that is a set of records. Now, let's see an example. Consider a database of students whose records are represented as 4 tuples, as we have already seen when I first introduced the topic, with the fields student name, ID number, major is either the department and the GPA. Now, these are the names of the students, the roll number, the department to which he belongs to, and the GPA. Now, with respect to that, relations that represent databases are also called as tables, since they are often displayed as tables. So, how do we display the table? The example which you have seen earlier. Here, this is a table. The student names are written in one column. The ID number is written in another column, the department or the major in the third, and the GPA in the fourth. Now, this row alone by itself is known as a tuple. So, these are all the tuples, and this is a record. If we have, in the case of a record, we can have more than one entry, while each of them by themselves is a field. Now, with respect to this database, or with respect to this table, what we do is we will study further subtopics on this databases and we will study it with relations.